Task done. Got my last gallon of Def in, so I should be about 60%.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto US 26 West.
And I have topped off the windshield wiper fluid. And we are mapped toward Binford in the mountains to the... Oh, how would you describe it? Around Casper, Wyoming, we'll say. South and west of Casper, Wyoming. Or south of Casper, Wyoming. But, should be fun. We're going to start our back roads driving through Wyoming. So secondary highways is going to be most of it, I think. But if there's some gravel, we're ready.
Turn right onto US 26 West.
Forgot to turn the AC on.
Keep right at the fork.
It's 80 on the interstate. I just can't get over that. Who knows 80?
In 2 miles, take exit 94 for El Rancho Road.
Getting on El Rancho Road. 2 miles. Ah, there is no merge lane at all. That is crazy. So I'm starting to see all my camper van buddies, van life people. I don't know if I even want one of those now, though, after the road I went on. Because if I would have had one of those and tried to go on the road, I probably would have been in the ditch. So this truck is even better than those vans, as far as where you can go. You're roughing it, that's for sure, but you could stay in a hotel once in a while, I guess. Or a campground.
Mile, take exit 94 for El Rancho Road.
What I like about the truck is I can do any road pretty much. Like, you know, it doesn't matter if it's gravel, rocky, dirt. Especially if it's dry, I can do any road. If it's wet, that's not really the case.
Take exit 94. In a quarter mile, turn left onto Wyoming 319 North East El Rancho Road.
What I like about these roads is I can start going to the bathroom when I need to. I was gonna go at the rest area, but I like, you know, I got the laptop.
Turn left onto Wyoming 319 North East El Rancho Road.
Truck, and I don't want to lock it in the bin right now.
Continue on Fish Creek Road for 8 miles.
Fish Creek Road. Alright. I'm happy to have made it to this area. Ooh. Rancho Road goes right. That was confusing. And there's an RV park and campground right here. Oh my gosh. It is way too long. They have little cabins you could rent. Or wait. That might. Yeah, they do. It's pretty cool. there's a couple of campgrounds up in this mountain we're gonna go through. Check them out. You don't realize there's all this stuff off of the interstate. You know, if you're just driving and using Google Maps, you have no idea. Just despise the interstates. You might as well fly in a plane if you're going to stay on the interstate. beautiful. Closer you get to the mountains.
Turn right onto Harris Park Road.
They look nice. And there's, I don't see any ranch around here. Oh, this is gonna be awesome.
Take the next right onto Harris Park Road.
Harris Park 13, Fletcher Park. Oh, Fletcher Park is straight. Oh wow, so we're getting on gravel. They're putting gravel down, it looks like.
Continue on Harris Park Road for 5 miles.
So, I think I'll just go 35 on this road. Be happy with that. Thank you. probably go a little faster, but just in case there's washboards all of a sudden. I hate having to slam on the brakes and start sliding. The whole back end of this truck does not like washboards. It wants to go off the road. It's so light. Wow, this is awesome. Wyoming, thanks for this awesome road. out here anywhere you want. Off the road, there's little pull-offs. It's like I found the work. They got a road grader up ahead. Dropping a rock.
In 1,000 feet, slight left to stay on Harris Park Road.
How far are you putting gravel down?
To the mailboxes.
Oh, okay. I love it to see gravel, like when you guys do maintenance on these roads. It's awesome.
Yeah, you live further down?
No, I just drive around these roads and go to the campgrounds.
Oh, yeah.
And it must be fun working on them, too, like just out here.
Yeah,
in the middle
it's
of nowhere.
Beautiful.
I was in...
To be out by Albany Peak and Elk and Buffalo and...
I saw a road grader like that in over west of Laramie in the mountains, north of... Oh God, what is it? That town in Colorado, Craig. And
Craig,
he was in the middle of nowhere.
Rifle.
Yeah, he was
I've
in
up there.
He was in the middle of nowhere in the mountains there, grading the whole road all by himself, and I'm like, that would be cool.
Cool job, no stress.
It'd be awesome. Well, have a good day.
You too, enjoy.
All right, bye.
Next left to stay on Harris Park Road.
Yeah, those guys are so lucky. I love talking to them. They're so nice.
Oh. Continue for 6 miles.
Private property. This way. So Google Maps almost...
Continue on Harris Park Road for 2 miles.
Almost took me down a private road. Google Maps, come on. I have to go that way. Huh. That is funny. I don't understand this. Google Maps is having trouble. She's not matching what my gazetteer is saying. So, a little confused. I hope I'm on the right road. is on the gazetteer, it says stay on Harris Park Road all the way to the top, which is what I plan on doing. I love this type of forest that you can see a lot.
Continue on Harris Park Road for 1 mile.
All right, she's got it right now. She was just confused. Awesome, we're good. Good to go. Every once in a while, Google Maps does not do a good job on these roads, but pretty impressed for the most part. It does do a good job. Wow, AT&T loves the rural areas of the Great Plains in Wyoming. Not Verizon, not so much. Oh, there's a house way down here. These are the kinds of back roads I like. They're really nice gravel / rock hardpack.
Quarter mile, turn left to stay on Harris Park Road. Take the next left to stay on Harris Park Road.
So basically, Google Maps.
Continue on Harris Park Road for 3/4 of a mile.
She'll see these old Jeep roads that are disappearing and think that, a car can go on it. Like that last one, you could barely see it. But she made sure I didn't take it. She said, take a left, take a left. It's pretty funny. Oh, this is beautiful. Like, I've always hated driving I-25 north through Wyoming. I didn't hate it, but it wasn't that fun. Because you're so far away from everything. You're like, on these roads, you're right up close to the mountains and you go into them. It's awesome.
Turn right to stay on Harris Park Road. Take the next right to stay on Harris Park Road.
Oh, wow. So I wonder if I could have went straight where it said private.
Oh.
No, you can't. It says dead end.
Continue on Harris Park Road for 3 miles.
Basically, someone was working on this. So I thought maybe it was the upper end of the bottom part of the road where I was talking to the guys. Yeah, you don't want to go on private property out here, for sure. If it says private, no entry, do not do it. are you saying private property? No. That can't be. Alright, I gotta go to the bathroom here. Alright. So I have 1 mile to get to the Forest Service Road. So I'm gonna assume that this private property sign means off of the road. Because this is not their road. And one car went by and another one's behind me, so people are using it. And I have 0.8 miles to Forest Service Road 633. It's very weird how they put it on the gate, the sign. They should put signs up in the grass. For people like me, it's confusing. But I think that's what they mean. I mean, that's what I would say if anyone stopped me.
Slight right onto FS-633. Take the next right onto FS-633. Continue for 1 mile.
Alright, well, hopefully this is a good road, because I'm on it for a while. Oh, respect private property, next 2 miles. Alright, so these are county roads, Forest Service roads, and you have a right to drive on them. I thought so. Wow, if this gets wet, this is gonna be muddy. I need to be on some better roads by the time the rain starts. Jeez. Binford. Alright. My only other option was to go left and that goes south. Sometimes it's a little confusing though when you're not familiar with the area. Mr. Cow, what are you doing here all by yourself? So there's one cow down here laying under the tree in the shade, all by himself. Pretty funny. I like cows. Oh wow, this is a camp on the left, Camp Laramie Peak. Not sure what kind of camp, but there's cows roaming the grounds. Aw, little baby calves. Watch out, buddy. Where are you going?
In 600 feet, you will arrive at your destination. You have arrived.
We'll find out though. Hopefully it gets better when I get off of the private land, because it is a Forest Service road though. Oh, it's a neat cabin. Oh, so peaceful up here. Bugs are flying in my window, I'm not sure. miles an hour.
Sharing your real time.
Road, it's definitely a remote road and narrow in places. Forest now. Medicine Bow National Forest. And I really hope the road gets better. So we are on Forest Service Road 633 right now. Started to get over, but then I noticed there's a drop off in a drainage pipe, so I was like, yeah, I better go through, I'll just go through the water. Oh my god. Oh, that. So I saw a spur road, it was 663, and I got confused because I'm on 633. leaving the National Forest already. I'm sure we'll enter it again. Hopefully get a little better traction going over all these rocks. Oh my gosh, I hope this does not get bad. Oh, it's always bad going down because of the erosion. Just riding the brakes, but I'm not going fast, so I hope they don't get hot. I should put it in low. This is almost like a Jeep road to me. Not something I would go on a lot. One more switchback and we're down. portion is down. We're out of this deep stuff. Oh, that was rough. That was rough. So I think what happens when it's that steep, all the little sand and gravel gets washed away from, you know, the erosion, and you're left with the rocks like that. How I see Jeeps, you just go slow. No rush. There's no way I would take highway tires on this road. Entering National Forest Land. I just passed road 663, so basically did a loop and joined back up with this road. Section. Yeah, this is tiring. It definitely gets tiring. Medicine Bow National Forest. And made some ruts. Alright, this might be one of the worst roads I've been on this trip, I would say. Well, the length of it also. And it's muddy, kind of. There's an awesome campground to my left down that road. This little side road. That would be cool. Trying to stay out of these massive ruts someone made. Yeah, if I need to be off this before it rains, otherwise I will be stranded till it dries. How the heck do you have a bridge rated for 34 tons out here on this road? That's a nice spot to camp too, on the right there. So the Medicine Bow National Forest is really big. That's why I did not go right, in case I started sliding. I can't believe this is still wet. Or I should say muddy. Slippery right there. Yeah, this is a little sketchy. Definitely need to get out of it before it rains. I think it's gonna get better because Google Maps saying I can go 34 miles in 1 hour. And if it stays like this, that ain't possible. Puddles, you can't see how deep the puddle is. This creek is called Three Cripples Creek. Brick campground is 2 miles in front of you. Wow, going right? That does not look like a passable road when it's wet. It's private land. Much better. entering national forest land. So we keep leaving and entering repeatedly. Leaving and entering. Oh, getting hot. 78 degrees, but I got no wind flow, so I'm not driving fast enough.
In 600 feet, turn left onto Harris Park Road. Take the next left onto Harris Park Road. Continue on Harris Park Road for 4 miles.
Through some of those rocks. I kind of want to see it. Let's go check it out. Esterbrook. This is a fee area? Are you kidding me?
Turn left toward Harris Park Road, USFRST Service Road 633, then turn right onto Harris Park Road.
Wow, this... I don't know how far I want to go. I don't think I want to see this. This is softer, I think. Yeah, we'll turn around. You know what? Let's keep going. I want to see. Drove all this way. This would be fun. This would be private. I should rest here in the shade, let the truck cool off. Jeez, this is pretty cool, actually. Wow. $10. Bear country. Huh. You know what? Let's see a little more. Sunset Hill Trail. There's a hiking trail off of this campground. That's way cool. We're going to actually end this video. We're going to make this the Esterbrook. Let me end it now. That was, I don't even know where I came from. We're just going to end this video. Thanks for watching.